Hello everyone, Alex here from warnoffkeys.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can schedule your Lambda functions to run at specific times. In this exact example, we're going to be checking an S3 bucket for files that are more than a day old and deleting them, and we could run this every 10 minutes, every hour, every day. I could show you guys how to set it up however you want. So I've created a new folder here called CRON jobs, which is the name of the service we're going to be using in order to do this. And I've navigated into that on my console. We're going to go ahead and run npm init-y, and we're going to make a new file called index.js. We're going to need to install the AWS SDK, and we can import that. We're then going to create a main function, which will be an asynchronous function that has an event. This event will be populated from AWS Lambda. We're then going to console log the event, just so in our logs we can see what exactly is being passed in. And for now, we're going to return an empty string. We're then going to say exports.handler equals main. This way Lambda has the actual access to this function. And we're going to want to create two methods. The first one is get objects, which is an asynchronous method. And the second one is going to be delete object, which is another asynchronous method that has a key property. This key is essentially a file name. However, in AWS S3, they call them keys. So the first thing we're going to want to do is we're going to get all of the objects. So const objects equals await get objects. Now in here, we're going to have to access S3. So we're going to create an S3 object. S3 equals new AWS.S3 with a capital S. And we're going to have this function return a new promise that has resolve and reject. We're going to create a parameter object, and this is going to hold some information that's going to be sent to S3, such as the bucket name, which will be, in our case, worn off keys. If we go over to the S3 buckets, we see that's our bucket name, and we have one file, which is more than an hour old currently. So we're going to go ahead and clean up all files that are more than an hour old. If we go back to our code, we can then say s3.listObjects. We're going to pass in the parameters, and we're going to have a callback that has error and result. We're going to say if there's an error, we're going to reject with that error. Otherwise, we're going to resolve with the result. So here we have the objects, and for now, we're just going to return objects. We can save this file, and if we go into a previous video tutorial, we can copy a test script that I have. This will be in the video description, so you can easily copy it. We're going to get rid of some of these parameters that we used in a previous video. And if we save this, we can run npm run test. And it gives us information right here. So we have a contents array. The file name or the key is filefromlambda.txt. As we can see, that's the same exact file name here. And we also have the last modified, which is going to be useful in checking the time. So that we have the objects, we can loop through them. So we're going to create a file of objects.contents. So we're going to create a for loop here. And before the for loop, we're going to say now equals new date dot get time. We're going to create a new constant called 1 hour, which will be 60 times 60 times 1,000. This will be the number of milliseconds in one single hour. So that we have the file, we're going to want to destructure a couple of things from it. We want the key, which is the file name, and last modified. So this will give us access to this timestamp right here. And then we can say a constant should delete now minus new date, passing in last modified dot get time greater than 1 hour. And we can console log should delete. And we're just gonna return an empty string for now. We can save this. And this should tell us if this file is more than an hour old. So we run this again with npm run test. We see should delete is true. I just uploaded a simple text file here. And if we run it again, we should see should delete is true for the first one and should delete is false for the second one, which I just uploaded. To make this a little bit more clear, we're going to place the first console log here with the key, which should be the file name. And if we run this, we now see the correct results here. So test.txt is less than an hour old, so we should not delete it. but file from lambda.txt is more than an hour old, so we should delete it. So with that said, we can say if should delete, we want to await delete object, we want to pass in the key. I also want to keep track of how many objects we've actually deleted. So I'm going to create a variable here called files deleted equals 0. And then inside here, we're going to say plus plus files deleted. The return is now going to be a string literal that said done deleted, files deleted files. And so that'll tell us how many files we actually deleted. And so now we have to work on this delete object. And this is going to return a new promise. We're going to create a parameter object similar to the file above, or the function above. It's going to have a bucket, which is worn off keys. And it'll have a key, which will just have the value passed in from the file. We're now going to say s3.deleteObject. We're going to pass in the parameters and a callback with error and result. If there's an error, we're going to reject. Otherwise, we're going to resolve with the result. So now we can go ahead and save this. We can run the code. We see it says done, deleted one file. And if we go back to our SRA bucket and we refresh, we now just see test.txt. So now that we have the code done, we're going to go ahead and actually upload this to a Lambda function. And then we're going to schedule that function to run every 10 minutes. So if we go over to our console, we can go to functions, and we're going to click on create function. We're going to name this worn off keys clean S3. And we actually need to create a new role for this. So we're going to go into services, IAM. We're going to go into policies and we're going to create a new policy using S3. We're going to want two actions. The first one is to list bucket, which is the name of the policy you need to actually list all the objects inside of it. It might be a little confusing because it should be named list objects, but it's called list bucket. So we're going to go into the list options and the list bucket. If we click on the question mark, we could see return some or all of the objects in a bucket. So that's what we're looking for. The second thing we do with this Lambda function is we go ahead and delete the objects. So under write, we're going to go down, we're going to look for delete object. So now we can specify exactly what resources we want. We can specify the bucket, which is worn off keys. We can specify the object, which will be inside of worn off keys, but it'll be any object. So we'll add a wildcard to the end of the RN right here. We click add. And review the policy. We can name this worn off keys S3 list delete. So it just describes the two things it can do. We're going to create the policy and then we're going to go over to our roles and we're going to create a new role that is used on Lambda. We're going to select the permissions we want. We're going to type in worn off keys S3 and we're going to see worn off keys S3 list delete, which is the policy we just created. We're going to go to tags. We're going to leave those blank. And we're going to name this worn off keys S3. Now that the role has been created, we can go back to Lambda. Under permissions, we can create this dropdown here. And we're going to click on an existing role. We might want to refresh because we created the role after we loaded this page. We could type in worn off keys and we see worn off keys S3, which is exactly the thing we just created. We can click on create function. And so now this function should have the ability to run the code. So now what we want to do is, because we only have AWS SDK installed, we can actually just copy this code into the inline editor because AWS SDK is installed on Lambda on the backend by default. And so we don't actually have to zip up our code and upload it that way. If you did have other dependencies, however, you'd have to go into reveal in file explorer. You'd have to select all the files and send the contents to a zip file and then upload it through actions, upload from a zip file. However, this works in this exact use case, so we could control S to save in the inline editor and click save at the top right. So if we refresh here, we see that there's a file still there and it's definitely from more than an hour ago. So we're going to add a trigger. We're going to select the trigger type. We're going to select event bridge or CloudWatch events. And we're going to go ahead and create a new rule. We'll call this one every 10 minutes. You add a rule description if you want. Make sure you select schedule expression. And here's examples, rate 1 day, or you can go to more advanced cron jobs like this one right here. We're going to keep this very simple. We're just going to say rate 10 minutes. And so this will make the Lambda function run every 10 minutes automatically. So now I'm going to wait 10 minutes and we can go ahead and check to see if the S3 bucket has have its item deleted. Okay, so I just refreshed. I have not actually ran this through a test or anything like that. And the object has been deleted. So this Lambda function did run once every 10 minutes. And so this is just one example of what you can do with this. Obviously, you could delete a table on a database. You could clear a Discord channel. You can send an email. There's a lot of things you can do with this. However, for the example, we just selected to delete old files in an S3 bucket. Thanks for watching this AWS tutorial. If you need help or have a video request, be sure to leave a comment down below or ask in the Warnoff Keys Discord, which can be found in the video description. If you want to learn more about AWS, consider clicking on one of the videos you see on your screen now.